organising it all, Matt. So must be excited about today.
Definitely. I mean, it's great to meet all of the sim racers here at the Visa Vegas E-Race in the lovely Luxor. We're off to the Venetian, the Sand Expo in a minute, to do a media day shoot. That's on the Wednesday. Thursday we've got some exciting activities coming up, and then all leading up to the race on Saturday.
Yeah, awesome. Thank you, Matt. Matt is our man. Here, come on.
Bono.
Bono, what do you reckon? Bono, don't be afraid. You're going to be in loads. Are you excited about today's breakfast? Oh, yeah, get him. Don't touch that hair. That's been brushed.
Hi guys. It's me, Rocco. Hi, how are you?
Are you looking forward to today?
Yes, I'm really good.
Do you like Vegas so far?
I love Vegas. Yeah? Especially sharing room with you.
Olli.
You're underdog.
Have you got anything to say to your fans? Lovely. Like in Vegas, tired?
Yeah, a little bit tired.
Yeah? How was that breakfast?
Good, actually. Yeah. Pretty. There was like chicken breast on the breakfast.
Enzo, get me a coffee. Servant Enzo, get me a coffee.
Olli, what do you think?
I love it.
Sexy.
My stomach fits in.
Nice. So I'm here with a couple of the Mahindra boys ahead of the Formula E. E Vegas.
You can do it.
Oh, Dom,
you
can do it. Sorry. What should these guys do? What's the rule?
The rule
do
is
not pass,
do not pass the red line.
Do not pass the red line.
So don't pass the red line, guys.
Yeah. Do you understand? Let's zoom into that face.
Yeah. I want to love you guys.
Oh my god. First time. Golfer, Tiger Woods, eat your heart out.
Professional golf.
Pro. Alexi, pro golf.
Yeah, I would try this at
football. Oh. Mate, that's still got some beef on it.
And hands like this.
Yeah.
Nice with the pair. Now I lost it.
With the team.
Hi guys.
Hi.
Aleksi, what do you think of the track?
Easy peasy. It's gonna be NASCAR all over the place, isn't it?
Do you love Talladega?
Talladega is my favorite track.
I know. Gregor, what do you reckon?
Yeah, it's a pretty long lap, but yeah, it should be fun.
Yeah. Olli?
What?
What do you reckon on the track?
What track? Is there a track?
Did you have lots of vodka last night?
We had our dinner. Jain.
Alright. Bono, any thoughts?
Yeah, trying to learn it.
Okay.
The thing to do. Basically, this line, I think this is the only way to go. Maybe if you can bring it more to the right, yeah, figure it out in your sector time, see what's quicker. Because I think sector one is already after this one. Yes. So play with that. If sector one, the line is right after this corner, figure out different styles in this corner because you can't take it two ways. Either push on turn three and give up turn four, or do the right thing and focus on the exit of turn four. Just straight after this, it's really important. This is flat out easily. So this is all losing time, you cannot give it up.
Here with the boys.
I love this. I love doing this.
Aleksi, what do you reckon before qualifying?
What?
Before qualifying.
Feeling pretty good. Yeah, let's see what happens.
Difficult. Olli?
Yeah.
Aleksi has been sandpacking all day and Enzo is pulling his strings out all the time. So I will be somewhere in the middle and having fun. Yeah. Crashing.
Gregor, how do you think you'll do? Been difficult.
Probably around B20.
Mid-20?
Yeah.
I like it.
Bono, how do you think you do?
No idea, man. No idea. We'll see. Try my best.
Where's Enzo? He's always walking off.
Enzo had another interview. More important than Team Redline.
Let's see. How do you think they're doing? It's not live.
He's gonna be fast. He's gonna be fast. He's gonna be fucking fast. And this guy, fast.
And this guy is like the best.
Yeah. Close to the wall though, on that right-hand apex.
The hairpin, left-hander in turn 5, then up past New York, over the Brooklyn Bridge. Quick left-hander. Little couple of bites on the throttle.
Oh my god, Bono pole. Bono pole.
Who is leading the way in this qualification race? This is how he did it.
We're going to see this pass for the leader to turn 5 there.
Oh, left a door open, didn't he?
Yeah. It's a risk. Oh, it's getting a bit messy already, isn't it?
Machiqua just crashed, man.
Contact.
Oh. Yeah, they've come together again, and Machiqua is sent spinning, facing backwards on the Brooklyn Bridge. He'll try and get it round, but that is not an ideal position to be in.
That guy.
Yeah. You're all in the same equipment, you could be in the same car, it's all equalised, and actually the driver talent really comes out.
Bono Huis is going to be starting from pole position. Alongside him on the front row is going to be Felix Rosenquist. Unfortunately, the two apt drivers of Lucas Degrassi and won't be taking the start because he has been taken away the last two drivers. But there go the green lights, and away goes Bono Huis, hurtling down towards the first corner. He gets the best start. Alongside him as they come down towards the first turn is Felix Rosenquist, going to be close enough to make a move. There comes a look up the inside from the Andretti car. They all squeeze through just about safely by the looks of things. But out across the line is Bono Huis, and he is sprinting away into the wall. Goes Patrick Holtzman. Patrick Holtzman coming together, I think, with an Andretti and ending up in the barriers. That looks like it may be the end of the German driver's race, unfortunately for him. Look, here goes Holtzman. Taps it back across in front of Da Costa. Yeah, nothing Da Costa could do.
Da Costa was completely the innocent party there, and that was it.
Bono Huis comes out again now to start lap 10 of 20. Here in the Visa Vegas E-Race, he is almost halfway to $200,000.
Yeah, but you've got to finish it to get any of it.
Yeah.
That's the key, right? I just want to see how he does this.
Oh, and look at this, three wide, Graham Carroll, Aleksi Uci and David Greco, and they're all off into the wall. Graham Carroll's on the inside, he's in front. Oh, and then Greco tries to turn in. Yeah. Aleksi Uci was there.
Three, I'd love to see that again. I'd love to see actually the corner before to see what caused that.
This is on board with Graham Carroll, so he thinks he's made it.
But he's already been clipped.
The two behind collide and go spearing into him. And here's Graham Carroll. Last lap, Felix Rosenquist gains 0.7 seconds on Bono Huis. Is this race on? Is the battle for $200,000 about to pick up? Bono Huis revving the engine. Both of them are. Who's going to be released first? Oh, the Mahindra was released first of Felix Rosenquist, but not quite enough. Well, they both make it out and through and out back onto the circuit. So Bono Huis Well, there's Olli Pakkala. Where's Olli Pakkala in the other Mahindra? That is going to be the question. According to those timing screens, that timing tower on the left-hand side, he's managed to take the lead of the race. We will find him on the circuit.
Yeah, he's leading. He's just gone through the sector one. He is leading the race.
And they're coming towards the line now. The checkered flag is getting ready.
He's
done
it, Jack.
It is. It's the victory for Olli Pakkala. But here's a look at the results. It's Olli Pakkala who takes the win. Bono Huis in second place. Third for Felix Rosenqvist. Fourth, Enzo Benito. Fifth, Aleksi Uusijakala. Hutu Lopez, Bird Apt, and Nelson Piquet Jr. completing the top 10.
Well, just after the race, news broke that the stewards had discovered a technical issue which gave an unfair advantage to Olli Pakkala, which means he's been given a 12-second time penalty, which moves him from first position into third, leaving Bono House the new champion of the Visa Vegas E-Race.
Right, just with Bono.
You need to get used to that.
Bono's just won Bono's just won $250,000. Bono, we're in Hugo
Boss.
Buy
this whole store.
Yeah, Bono could buy the store. What do you need there? Here we're leaving from the hotel to go back home. Long journeys for all of us. As you can see, the team, we managed to get five of the top six, and just incredible. So start off with sixth place. That was
Gregor.
Sorry, Gregor.
Wow.
Gregor. So Gregor, how was your weekend? Pretty tough at first, wasn't it?
Yeah, practice was really awful. Didn't really get any kind of feel for the car. So yeah, I was really struggling, and I was thinking I will do really badly qualifying, but was able to improve my lap time like almost a second. So yeah, qualifying was really good. So
yeah,
race was a bit messy, especially the start, and had damage all race. So sixth place is great after all that stuff.
Yeah, well done, man. That was good comeback. Aleksi,
hi there.
Where did you finish? So Aleksi, tell me, right, because in practice you were struggling, then suddenly in qualification you pulled out one of the fastest laps. What happened? What changed?
Well, in the practice sessions I was just pushing too much and making mistakes, and qualification you have to do two fast laps and you can't mess that up, so I just needed that extra pressure, and it went well. So P3 in qualifying, and the race actually I had that accident with David and Graham, so lucky to survive from that, and secure the P5 with the broken car, so unbelievable.
Yeah, well done. Let's go to Enzo. Enzo.
Yeah, hello guys. Ciao.
So you managed to get an awesome fourth actually overall.
Yeah, managed to.
How's it gone?
Well, I started in ninth and I finished in P4. Well. Practice didn't went too well. I managed to understand the car in race, I think. That's why I gained some position. But in practice, it wasn't going really good.
That's good. And with fourth, you took home how much?
42 grand or so.
42 grand.
Not too bad.
Pretty good. Now we go to Olli and Bono, which is a bit of a... So Olli, I know your weekend was pretty tough as well, but you were still relatively on the pace and then in the race. Give us a breakdown.
Yeah, in general I think I lost the most pace in Friday free practice. I got too tired and I wasn't able to maximize the effort in the free practice on Friday. So it was a struggling on Saturday. Race worked really well. I made an undercut and used the fan boost in the very next lap and made a pretty good lap time, and I thought let's do it, and kept on going, and then I started noticing like my lap times are two seconds faster than normally, and started hitting left rev limiters in straight line, and I was like, okay, what's happening? And then there's nothing much I could do, so I...
So it stuck on, was it?
Yeah. So yeah, I finished the race and was quite scared what's gonna happen. So first thing for me was important that I told immediately to Bono and Felix that there's something wrong and relax. Bono got a bit of emotional there, but it went well. We went straight to the stewards. I told them what was the situation, and then they did the math and dropped me back to P3, which is
a podium, stunning result.
It's a great result, thinking where I started P6, and it could have been even worse. Could have been better, obviously, but yeah. P3 is great, and I really love the event. It's massive leverage for the sport, for sure.
Well done, man. And then we go to Bono. Bono actually all weekend pre-practice.
Yeah.
Straight on it.
Went well from the start.
Yeah.
Just faster than every session, so.
Yeah.
Went well from the very first lap and then kept it all the way. Just at the end of the race, a little bit of tension.
Yeah, and the Super Pole lap. Felix did a quite a fast one.
Felix had a really good lap, 28.8, I think. Yeah.
Did you feel pressure? I know you'd done like a 28.1 in practice.
Yeah, pressure was insane. I mean, one try for 25k. Yeah. Was not fun. But
so in the race.
Yeah.
Tell us about that, because you started and you were pulling away, but towards the end you hit some backmarker incident, right?
Yeah, start was good. He got a good lead by 5 seconds and then got a backmarker and he wouldn't let me go. So I had to make a risky move and I was on the inside and he just turned in on me.
And
so
you made contact.
Yeah, massive damage. Steering was bent like this for 10 laps. So lap times were still good actually after that.
Yeah, and you must have been surprised and wondering what was going on.
What the fuck was going on?
Okay. Sorry about that, children.
Oh, sorry, I'm Dutch.
So yeah, but so tell us, you've just made 225k.
Yeah.
Oh, what are you going to spend it on?
He's going to buy a girlfriend.
This guy.
I have no idea, man. Yeah? No idea what I'm going to do.
Yeah, but still, it could be life-changing cash.
It is.
And I think life-changing cash for a lot of us as well, just to have that buffer. So,
yeah.
Anyway,
sure.
Next year. Well done.
See you guys.